Hi guys, my name is Alex. Welcome back to our channel. It's EO's Marketplace News. Now for today guys, I will be giving you the latest and the most trending topic in the crypto world. So I know that you are excited, but before I start, I'm hoping that everyone is doing great today. All right, so guys, let's start. This news is brought to us by PCN or Preferred Currency News. A 7-year legal fight led this dev to build unstoppable Ethereum storage. So, if you build it strong enough, the law will follow. All right. Now, that's how Daniel Nagy, the leading developer behind Swarm, Ethereum's decentralized storage layer, described his takeaway lesson. After a 7-year legal battle over the hosting a file-sharing node, a precursor to peer-to-peer file-sharing service BitTorrent, Nagy was running a DC node, a technology that is now perfectly and completely obsolete, according to the developer. "I had a bit of a legal fight over it, and I won," he told CoinDesk. In the aftermath of that fight, Nagy, who founded of the Hungarian branch of the Electronic Frontier Foundation, joined the Ethereum Foundation, where he was inspired to look deeper into censorship-resistant technology. In particular, Nagy's experience in the courts initiated his work on Swarm, a hotly anticipated storage layer for Ethereum, where he focuses on systems architecture and privacy preserving cryptography. With Swarm, Nagy is fixated on how to make decentralized storage robust enough that legal repercussions of this kind can't happen, in what he describes as an arms race between developers and regulators. This is an arms race, and since we can develop stuff and the marginal cost of replications is zero, we will win this arms race. And I think everybody knows that, he told CoinDesk, an Ethereum initiative that has been active since the early days of the platform. Swarm seeks to provide a mechanism for the blockchain to offload some of its historical data, as well as handle file storage more broadly, with an emphasis on efficiency, speed, confidentiality, and security. The decentralized storage layer is built with the aim of rendering the cost of attack so inefficient that the legal system is forced to update itself in response. According to Nagy, that's because a fully robust network can actually inform decision-making, even to the point of how law is interpreted by judges and enforcers. So he told CoinDesk they won't want to enforce enforceable laws. Okay. Unstoppable storage, intended to provide a base infrastructure for a decentralized internet. Swarm splits information up between the computers of different network participants to protect this layer from censorship. What Nagy defines as taking information out of circulation, decentralization and privacy are vital. For example, what developers call redundancy is key to how Swarm protects against censorship. This refers for the duplication of critical system components of a system, creating in effect a swarm of machines. So if you have multiple channels of communication, multiple locations of storage, then censoring becomes more expensive because you need to find all of them and shut down all of them, he told CoinDesk. While it's possible to store information in a transparent way on Swarm, much of Nagy's work has focused on how to ensure sensitive information remains private, even when stored in someone else's computer. To do this, Swarm uses what is called counter-mode encryption. If there's a dispute, the protocol shares a small piece of encrypted data that can verify ownership without revealing any other information. So in order to access the stored information remotely, Swarm uses public and private key pairs. As such, participants will host encrypted data chunks on their laptops, and in most jurisdictions can do so with a degree of plausible deniability, also meaning that because Swarm nodes don't hold the keys to unlock data, they won't be at risk of legal trouble. According to Nagy, that's important because attack-resistant storage is essential to healthy societies. Storage is a shared experience of humanity, he told CoinDesk, adding, the difference between hunter-gatherers and us is exclusively the amount of stored information that we have access to. There is no other difference between us. Okay, so a seven future directives. The storage protocol is currently in public alpha, meaning that while still under heavy development, but today anyone can run a swarm node. Going forward, the protocol will also offer incentives in the form of Ether or Ethereum's native cryptocurrency for participants in the Swarm network. This aspect is still being fine-tuned. Additionally, according to Nagy, Swarm encryption has been designed to be as smart contract friendly as possible. So in order to ensure that dApp developers can seamlessly integrate the technology, that's because while primarily intended to store smart contract information and other blockchain data in a decentralized way, Swarm has other more far-reaching use cases on the horizon. For example, the project has secured a number of partnerships over the past year, including video streaming, startup LivePeer, and DataFund, a privacy-centric data management protocol. Nagy is also using Swarm to build a censorship-resistant social media platform called BeFree, working with fellow Ethereum Foundation developer Dmitry Kokhlov. Their goal is to use the technology in a bid to create an alternative to platforms with heavier forms of censorship. So we have access to a kind of shared pool of knowledge that humanity has accumulated. And if that is being censored, that makes us much dumber as a society, Nagy said. All right. So guys, this is for the latest news and most trending topic for today. Now, I know that you want more news and updates, so please visit preferredcurrency.news. Be the first one to get notified of the new updates, okay? When you subscribe, right, guys, I assure you, you will be the first one to get notified of the new updates if you subscribe. You can use your preferred method. You can use your PayPal for a monthly recurring for only $15 per month fiat. Or you can use the Coinbase option for $180 annual subscription to be paid with crypto. Yes, that's to be paid with your favorite crypto. All right. So, guys, introducing the man behind preferredcurrency.news. His name is Donald Lewis, or Donald the Guru. You can call his number at 1-801-601-8105. You can add him on WhatsApp. It's 1-801-471-6939. You can add him on Skype. His Skype ID is donald.capitalfcda. You can follow him on Twitter at Preferred Crypto. You can join our Telegram channel, which is preferredcrypto.news, and you can send a private message to Donald Lewis at Preferred Crypto on Telegram. All right, but if you like, you can also send us a message directly here on the website. Your name and your email is required, and of course, your message. And just hit send. And guys, please, please, please subscribe now. All right. So, guys, if you also subscribe, you can be one of our affiliates. Okay. You can just click this link and it will take you to the page where it says the instructions on how to become one. All right. Now, guys, let me show you what will you be getting when you subscribe to Preferred Currency News. Here, you will be getting a newsletter every day. All right. On the newsletter, the available or the articles of the day will be on the first part, okay, or the upper part of the newsletter. Of course, there are a lot of websites for you to check and for you to, you know, benefit from it, because these websites really have a good content. Like, for example, if you are looking for a website where you can add your listings, there is a suggestion here, which is eosmarketplace.news, or marketplace.pcn.today, so you can place your additional listings there. All right. So, guys, the most important part of the newsletter is the Donald's research list. Here, let me show you. The Donald's research list cannot be found anywhere else on the internet, but only here at preferredcurrency.news. Now, this what do you call this one? This spreadsheet tells all. Yes, it tells all because it is a list. The spreadsheet shows a list of tokens or coins. It's complete. Yes, it is. It's really complete. And guys, when you can see, maybe you're asking, why is there yellow? Why is there green? Why is there blue? All right. So guys, when you can see the name of a token or coin that has a blue color, it means that it is showing the best news. All right. Red have negative news. Orange or tan are neutral. Yellow are fair. Green have good news. And again, blue are showing the best news. Okay, so when you subscribe to preferredcurrency.news, you can have a copy of this Donald's research list so that you can check and you can compare the recent status of the coin or token and the previous right status. All right, so let me show you an example for today, Bitcoin. So let's see, let's keep track. What is the status of Bitcoin? So for Bitcoin as of today, USD recent price, it's 6,366.12617269. Share of total market volume is 0.31929897. Google searches compared to the past 7 days, it's 59%. It's already crossing down 50 for SMA movement. Number of positive technical indicators 3, 24 hours volume versus price 0, 7 days volume versus price 201.69, 30 days volume versus price it's 30.97, and percentage it's 82.72%. All right, now if you like to see or if you like to check another token or coin that is not here, you can just simply control F and then type. Right, I like EOS. I like to know what's the current status of EOS. For EOS today, it's used your recent price. It's 5.31516171. Share of total market volume 0.0537264 8. Google searches compared to the past 7 days, it's 90%. It's crossing down 50. Number of positive technical indicators 2. 24 hours square and volume versus price 0.46. 7 days volume versus price is 50.23. 30 days volume versus price it's 71.94, and percent and should it's 90.06%. Right, so guys, see, it's very user friendly, it's very easy to access, very easy to use, very understandable, it's easy to understand, right? So guys, this is the advantage of Donald's research list. You don't need to open a lot of websites or to remember websites for you to keep track of tokens and coins, because only here at Preferred Currency News, we will be the ones who will notify you what are or what is the current status of that coin. But please remember, this sheet is not a recommendation to buy or sell. All right, because guys, we here at EOS Marketplace News, we are not financial advisors, so we highly recommend that you do your own research and then you can decide for yourself. Okay, now that's it for today's news and most trending topic. This is Alex once again. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and don't forget to leave a comment. All right. Thank you so much for today, guys, and I hope to see you soon again. Bye.